Good morning. I'd like to welcome you to the Berks Community Action Program on BCTV. My name is Jodi Readinger. I'm BCAP's Community Relations Coordinator. We are live today, February 7th, in the BCTV studios. We have a call-in number, our number 610-378-0426. Today, I'm really excited. I have three guests with me, and we're going to talk to three young men who came to Reading in different ways, born, transplanted, had an opportunity to leave and see some more of the world, and came back and are now dedicated to making their community a better place, and fits so well into the goal of the Berks Community Action Program and Community Action. So we're thrilled to be able to share their stories today and their visions for the community. We're going to start at the far end with our own fatherhood initiative, promoting responsible fatherhood, and yes, mentor program coordinator, Stephan Fains, who grew up in the city, has had a variety of experiences in the city and outside of the city, and has landed at BCAP for the last couple of years, and definitely works very hard in the community. He's out and about everywhere, as you can attest by his Facebook and all the pictures he posted, but has seen a lot of the world through his experiences and came back and said, you know, this is where I want to raise my family and this is where I want to make a difference in the community. Next to Stephan is Brad Waples, who is the is a partner in Custom It Printing on South 4th Street, which you can't describe on a half an hour program because he does a little bit of everything. But he has an incredible amount of ideas. He has lived in Washington, D.C. and traveled all over the place and decided to make Reading his home, where he's raising his family and where he wants to make his community a better place. And right next to me is a new friend that I met today, Jeff Dorestant, who is a partner in SoFit Gym, which is over by Schlegel Park, right?
Yeah.
And definitely committed to making the community a better place, has reached out to Stephan and everybody else at BCAP, has been out and about in the schools and saying, okay, you know, I got this space, let's do something. Let's do something for the kids in our community, give them some better opportunities. So I got an incredible panel today. I shouldn't have to talk too much. I may have to smack them on the back of the head once in a while to make sure they don't talk too much too. But I'm really thrilled, as you know, I've been at BCAP for 25 years and I've seen lots of people come and go, and it's really great to see those that are a couple of years younger than me that are coming up and are going to take the place of people that are retiring, not quite me yet, but my colleagues that we are seeing retire over the last couple of years, that know that there's somebody else in place that really wants to make the community a better place and can sometimes relate a little bit better to our kids. So Brad, we're going to start with you. Tell us a little bit about what Custom It is and your plans for the community. And I cannot endorse you because of federal regulations, but Brad is a candidate for city council in the 3rd district?
5th district.
5th district.
Okay. I am the co-owner of Custom It AFP LLC, which is Custom It Art Fashion Print. We actually are a 3-tier corporation. We own Custom It Art and Fashion Shop, which is our art and fashion shop. We sell art and fashion related products from local and regional brands and artists. We are located on 20 South 4th Street. Then we also own Custom It Printing, which is our printing and promotion company. We do screen printing, vinyl printing, signs, banners, decals, stickers, apparel customization, and much more. And then is our third company, Custom It Promotions, where we do promotion, marketing, event promotion, planning, campaign marketing, promotions. We do a various amount of different things. One of the big things we do with Custom It Promo is we do a lot of local events where we bring in local and regional performing artists, DJs, producers, dancers, all different types of things, and we try to create a space and place for them to showcase their talents and skills, as well as network with other artists and like-minded individuals in the area to try and create a true art hub or true art scene in the Reading area. That's in a nutshell what we do at Custom It AFP. And my partner, Tracy Soto, we've been open at our 20 South 4th Street location since April of 2016. We've been in business as Custom It AFP, well, as an official business since 2015, but me and him have been together for over 5 years doing this thing, and we've grown a lot, and we've experienced a lot, and it's been through those experiences as a young entrepreneur, going through those hurdles and challenges to get to where we are, that has made me want to do so much more in the community to try and help cut that learning curve, or help cut that time gap for so many other young entrepreneurs to be able to pursue their dreams and goals and really make a difference in the community.
And I know you've mentioned to me before that you've been very fortunate to have a mentor or several mentors.
Yes.
But I know you've mentioned our former mayor, Tom McMahon.
Yes.
And that, you know, that's so important that for young people to realize, you know, while we want to act as their mentor, we too still have people that we call, that we look up to, and when we have a question, we go to, that have shaped our lives.
Yes. Like you said, Tom is really influential in a lot of the decisions and things that I've done. When we sit down from time to time, Tom and a lot of other local business people who have their hands in a lot of the important things that are happening in Reading. I find it important to find those people who have experiences and have years on you in your field, and sit down and be able to talk with them and share in their knowledge and their experiences and help to guide and direct you. And I've been fortunate enough to be able to meet and talk and develop relationships with a lot of the founders, or a lot of the people who have been very influential in business and in shaping the community and culture of Reading. And I do very much feel that it's important to, one, be able to identify different mentors and different people who can help you along. But two, it's also very important for those mentors or people to have a openness and willingness to be there to guide and want to bring younger people into the fore. I think that's one of the very important things that we have struggled with in Reading, is that we've had really great businesses, really great entrepreneurs, but we've struggled in that gap between the ones who are doing it and the next generation coming up. And I think that is very important for us to work on helping to bridge that gap and helping to bring the younger generation into the fold, and helping to give as much of the energy, as much of the information, knowledge, time, whatever that can be given to help move the next generation forward. I think that's very detrimental to the growth and prosperity of Reading.
And I think it's so important that they see small business owners in our city. So, Jeff, you were telling me this morning that you were born in Haiti and came to Reading by way of New York.
Right.
And traveled a little bit and now came back. So tell us a little bit about your business and your vision for how you can reach out to the youth in the community.
Yeah, our business is SoFit LLC. We're on 100 North Carroll Street. We do personal training, group training, athlete training, kids training, any type of training that has to do with the human body. Helping people to rehab back into life. It's really, really dynamic when you can change someone's life completely. Taking someone that was at health at risk, some of them are close to their deathbed, and mm-hmm. we can have a complete reversal and be able to impact people's life in this way. And it's incredible what we're able to do with our business.
And you told us before that you wanted to reach out and work with students in the schools and the sports teams and things like that. Have you been able to do anything like that, or is that still in the planning process?
Yeah, so what we're able to do is we took our Saturday. We have a Saturday program that we started. It's just for everyone, but really we're the most people that we have coming in right now is kids.
Okay.
We have a lot of youth, a lot of kids that come on our Saturday program. And basically we started the Saturday program because my partner and I started looking at the statistic of Reading, Pennsylvania. And the statistic of Reading, Pennsylvania is alarming. You know, it's Reading is 10th in the cities of the poorest in health.
Wow.
At risk in health is number 10. And that is very alarming. In the city that I'm able to impact, I'm a personal trainer. If you're a doctor or anyone that in the health field, this is what we do. And to have that, it's alarming. It, you know, we're 24th And Pennsylvania as a state, we're 24th in the state of the poorest health.
Wow.
And Reading in itself is 10th. And then it goes on to go how many, you know, we're 19th in strokes. We're like, you know, 20th in heart attacks. And it goes on and on. And once we started seeing those alarming numbers, we said, we have to do something because there's something wrong here. And we took the Warrior Wellness Initiative, and under the Warrior Wellness Initiative, we took we started a class called Fit Future. And Fit Future is we want the kids and the youth and even parents to bring their kids along to start doing different things with their kids. You know, a lot of these kids now, they're watching TV, video games, you know, everyone is stuck on the computer, tablets, phones. I mean, the kids, you know, at 4 or 5 years old, they know how to do more stuff on the phone than I know how to do on the phone. So we said, you know, we have to do something that gets them involved. And, you know, we started this class, and it's fun, it's activity, you know, the parents do it along with the kids, and sometimes we separate the older, the younger kids, because we have kids starting from 5 years old, five and all the way up to nine, and we kind of separate them in the group, and then 10 and up, we have them in a different group, and then we sometimes separate the adults, but sometimes the adults will do the stuff with their, you know, if they brought little kids, and they'll enjoy and enjoy the activities along with them, too.
So are you able to put in place anything in terms of reaching out? I mean, you're doing a great job reaching out to the community and offering that kind of stuff, but are you doing any internships or anything with the schools in that? I mean, I don't know what your educational background is. I mean, what do you have to do to become a personal trainer?
Right, so you have to get certified. You have to, either some, you can go to school and get certified, you can take a class and get certified. We haven't started any internships yet, but we're open for internships. We've been reaching out. We have a couple of guys that kids from the colleges that are taking courses already, and that needs the hands-on experience. So they've reached out to us already, of saying, you know, they want to shadow us, and we're willing to do that in that aspect.
That sounds great. And you have a fairly large facility. Is that what I've been told?
Yes.
And you're open to community events over there. And
yeah.
And how many trainers do you have? What's your capacity?
It's the two right now. It's two of us, and it's three of us that do the Fit Future Warrior Wellness Initiative.
Oh, and okay. In terms of advertising that, do people need to sign up for that, or show up on a Saturday morning?
Yeah, just show up on a Saturday morning. The way we do it, we just have people just show up on a Saturday morning. It's Saturday morning at 11 a.m. And once they show up, then they, you know, they do your sign in and all that stuff. But we advertise it through Facebook. We try to get flyers out there. We try to call other organizations that we know that have kids, you know, have them reach out to us, and you know, our contact stuff, and you know, let's get this going. This is very important. You know, we cannot do anything in the community if we don't have health. You know,
that's
you
true.
Can't build wealth without having health. You can't build anything if you don't have your health. It's one thing I believe in, helping people find their purpose and what they're born to do. And we both believe that, my partner Kashmir and I, we believe that. And one thing we say together, we said, it's one thing for me to help you find what you're born to do without having the health to do it. If I help you find what you're born to do, your purpose in life, and you go ahead and out there and you could only do it for 3 days or 3 months, you just did myself and the rest of the world a disservice, because you don't have the health to last and fulfill that gift.
Okay, so we're meeting artistic needs, we're meeting physical needs. So Stephan, you want to give us a nutshell about your outreach activities with, they've been doing some neat stuff with fatherhood.
In the fatherhood program, you know, we're doing what we usually do. Right now it's a little cold out there, so if you got guys in need of things, we've been having, well, Jody's given me some hand warmers, we got gloves, blankets, things like that to try to keep guys warm. Any guys that's been out there looking for jobs, I've been taking guys out to the temp agencies, to Ashley's Furniture. I mean, anywhere they want to go, basically. If you have a job you're looking for somewhere and you need help getting there or getting the clothes, the shoes to do it, we've been doing a lot of that this year. Also, recently partnered up with the Olivet Boys and Girls Club over at Clinton Street. We're doing some mentoring and some basketball training. and that's went really well. First week was last week, had about 12 to 15 kids. We'll be there again this week on Friday, and all you have to do is be an Olivet member, and okay. you can get in.
Oh, that's great, and that fits in with the, we hear a lot, you know, coming through our funding sources and things about a two-generational approach to poverty. So we're, you know, reaching out to the parents, and we're reaching out to the kids, and we're trying to do what we can do. We're working on their physical wellness, and you brought up some great points. I do not keep track of my physical health as much as I should. But I'm very active,
right.
You know, and I don't know that I'd have time for a weekend warrior. You know, running from place to place counts. I'm always doing physical fitness. But, you know, we have to keep the health component because you can't do anything without good health.
Yeah.
And we see that as a side effect sometimes of poverty.
Yes.
You know, the nutritional foods are harder to get.
Yes.
On food stamps, we have food deserts, we have things like that.
Yes.
So you bring up a good thing, and then Brad, you got a whole lot of stuff going on in that. I know you want to do some classes for kids, and
yeah.
and you're always, you know, your shop is always open for anybody that wants to come in and help. And Steph and I encountered a mother of a young man who just graduated from Albright that's looking for something to do. He has a degree in fashion, and immediately we went, oh, let's call Brad. So definitely reaching out and mentoring and trying to get projects going. And you know, your production part, you also did a really neat project with some videos about fatherhood and male roles.
Yeah, like I said, with Customer Promotions, we do a various amount of video projects and things of that nature. We actually have a litany of videos that will be released in the next couple months. As you alluded to, we did a segment where we thought it would be neat to get the stories and reactions of young fathers and their experiences, because we felt that they're not often told. It was actually a side thing that we did when we started another project that we were doing, and while we were doing that project, we thought, you know what, let's maximize the potential of what we can accomplish here and what we can collect as far as data and experiences. So we had four or five different artists that came in for music interviews that we're doing through Customer Promotions. And we actually, Stephan actually happened to be there that day, and we thought about trying some fatherhood questions, and we also threw out some political questions. So we thought it would just be interesting, because as a young generation, you don't really get to hear the voices from the young generation in a professional manner. You get your community journalism with Facebook and Twitter and whatever other social medias, but you never actually get to hear their voices packaged in a professional manner and presented to an audience in a palatable manner where you can really digest the information and really say, you know what, this is something impactful. And we thought it was really neat and interesting to hear some of the reactions and hear some of the stories that just aren't told. So we will be releasing some of that stuff in the near future. And we hope to continue the series and hope to grow it and hope to do a lot more of these informative community-oriented projects.
It's always interesting what kind of answers you get when you ask a question. And I know we've, you know, Stephan found out with fatherhood when he posted something on Facebook at the response. Sometimes dads and young dads get a real bad reputation in our city because there's a lot of absentee fathers, there's a lot of single mothers, there's a lot of dads that don't live with their kids. And we are seeing and very happy to highlight quite the opposite.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, definitely, you know, dads that are very involved in their children's lives that are living with their kids, a number of single dads. You know, Stephan's got five of his own. And I know, Brad, you have a daughter, right?
I do.
And Jeff, do you have any children?
I don't have any.
Okay. He dodged that bullet.
<Yeah. laughs>
But that's so important, because as our society changes, it definitely, you know, my hats are off to single moms who do it and balance it all, but it's so much easier with two parents. It's so much easier when, you know, both parents are involved, and definitely those dads that are doing it by themselves.
Yeah.
you know, we definitely want to recognize those. And that's some of what your conversations did. You know, let's recognize these dads that are doing it, that they're not all deadbeat dads, and they're not, you know, all minority fathers are not all, you know, out living on their mom's sofa, you know, making babies while moms are taking care of them.
Well, and the crazy thing is, like, ever since we were about 16, 17, Brad's been on this thing. Like, that's why I always come in. He kind of is the reason why I do what I do, because he been doing all this stuff, helping the community, making t-shirts for the community. He's been doing this stuff forever. And since we were kids, he's like, you know what? We need to start going to city council meetings. I'm like, man, get out of here. We're kids. What are we? He's like, no, this is important. We got to know what's going on in our city. We got to know. We're young fathers. We got to know what's going on in the world. We got to know how to help. So, I mean, he's always been on this path to, he just wants to know what's going on in the city and why aren't we doing something to help it? Like, we live here, right? So let's have an impact. Let's do something about it. And then that's why I bring both these guys, because even me and Jeff, when he came to me right away, it was, I want to help Reading. It wasn't I want to help myself. It was, how can I help kids of Reading eat better or lose weight, or what can I do to help, you know? And that's what we got to do as kids of the community. It's going to take us to help it become a better community, because Reading wasn't always what it is now. You know what I mean? It was a better place before.
100% agree.
Well, that eating better is going to be hard with chicken pot pie and Foss nuts.
Well, you and don't forget, Jodi brings in cakes and pies.
I think one of the things that we also miss is that being in Reading, we are actually smack dab in the middle of Kutztown and Lancaster County, which when you talk about huge farm industries and you talk about fresh and organic food, they're right there.
Around them.
And they're right there. And then even going further, when we talk about being young adults and young entrepreneurs, one of the big things that's going on now when you look at urban trends is indoor organic farming.
Right.
And that's
urban
something
farming.
Exactly.
That's a whole nother show. With
there's plenty of opportunities and things that are available that are right in our backyard that we can open our eyes and be more progressive in looking at opportunities and things that exist right here to better our community and make it healthier, make it more inviting and a better place to live for all.
And I definitely have to say, since Stephan came on board and we've been doing the youth initiatives at BCAP, I have become aware of so many things in our community that I didn't realize happened.
Right.
You know, all the opportunities that are out there for youth, all the opportunities that are out there for young people. And that's been great. And we've been trying to share that through our BCAP channels, through our individual channels, that the opportunities that are out there and the things that are coming to Reading. And I think the city, it's not what it was 40 years ago. But it's different, it's growing, it's changing, and it's changing with the needs of our community. Okay, so as we wrap up, one last question for all three of you. Somebody wants to help out in their community. You guys are doing it. What is a good first step? How do you get involved? Stephan?
Reach out to me over at BCAP 376-6571, and I'll plug you in wherever you need to go.
I'm a shameless plug first, but I'm going to give you some other insight as well. We can also be reached at Customer AFS or Customer AFP, 610-829-9342, or you can always stop by at 20 South 4th Street. We do a bevy of different events every weekend, so you can always come check that out. But I would also just say that I really feel that this is the time, I call it the Nike generation. It's just about getting up and just doing it. Whatever it is that you want to do, there's an opportunity out there somewhere. You just have to actually want to do it and pursue it. I think that's the number one answer to anything that you want to get accomplished.
Yeah, along with those guys too, you can find us on SoFit, our Facebook, our Instagram, and we are 100 North Carroll Street. I believe in being proactive, just like both of these guys mentioned. But I also believe in when you have you have to do something that makes you mad. Like, me seeing people being sick makes me mad because I know there's an opposite end to that. We can do something about that. So if something make you mad enough that you want to do something about it, that's the thing that you do, because you know that's what makes you angry. Find a thing that makes you angry and do something about it.
I love that. That what a great way of, you know, finding your passion.
Right.
Find what makes you upset. And we, you know, long-term employees at BCAP, we tend to get up on our soapbox a lot of times, especially when people are talking about welfare moms and people on food stamps. And but, you know, educating the community is a great thing, and finding what you're passionate about and what you want to change in the community. And I would say, you know, we've got some great first steps. You know, just start, whether it be something as simple as, you know, volunteering at an event, or, you know, going cleaning up the park. You know, we've done a lot of that. But, you know, just finding something you're passionate about and making sure your talents are utilized to the max. Okay. Boy, a half an hour flew by. I want to thank all three of my guests, Stephan, Brad, and Jeff. They did shameless plugs for their businesses, but you can find them all over Facebook, social media, or you can give us a call at BCAP, and we can certainly get you in touch with them. And I hope that we'll be doing lots of projects with both of them. I know Stephan, we will. I don't even go to his office anymore. we'll do lots of projects over the next several months. So I'd like to thank BCTV, thank BCAP, which provides us this opportunity, and for everyone at BCAP, where we believe a neighbor in need is a call to action. Thank you.